Hey guys, this is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're going to run three different samples from one of our customers from Germany. He sent these over DHL, and there's three different samples with three different characteristics. This one is more like an electronic shred, a bunch of wires. They've all gone through some various stages of magnetic separation, but you know, there's still quite a bit of steel in this one. And I think the goal here is going to be to liberate some more of the copper wire from the plastic and also get the remaining steel out of this one. This is the second sample we're going to run, and this is mostly steel. There may be a little bit of stainless in here, but I think a lot of this is steel. It'll suck out with a magnet. There's a piece of stainless that'll go through. But the magnet will pull out the ferrous, and all the non-ferrous, like the copper wire, the stainless, and the aluminum will go through. And this is the third sample he sent, which is mostly rubber and plastic. There is some copper wire in here and a little bit of ferrous and probably aluminum as well. So we're going to run it through our HD hammer mill with a half-inch screen and then under the mag belt. And try and pull out as much ferrous as we can, and we'll show you what comes out the backside. This is the hammer mill we're going to be running the samples through today, and this is our 24 by 16 HD hammer mill, and especially designed for scrap metal processing. We have ribs on the top and the back here. It has between 12 and 24 hammers depending on your application. And the screen in the bottom is a 1-inch thick screen, rolls all the way 180 degrees on the bottom of this case. And it has, this current screen has half-inch slots about 3.5 inches wide. It's run with a 30-horse electric motor. It will discharge down onto this conveyor belt, which you can either have a guy hand-picking here if you wanted, or have it go continuous up under the magnetic separation belt here. This will pull out the ferrous material. We're going to use this tray to catch the ferrous from each sample. And then the non-ferrous will continue up the conveyor belt and discharge off the end of the conveyor. This is one of our zigzag separators. We do not have the air classifying system set up, so this is just going to be a chute for today. But the way this works is when the air is hooked up here, you pull a vacuum up from the bottom. The heavy material comes through across the airflow up, and it carries the light paper, light plastic, anything, string, the fluff will go up into the sucker, and the heavier dense metals will come down through the bottom. So this is the stuff that was pulled out by the magnetic cross belt. And at first we thought we were getting a bunch of copper wire in with our steel. But then we realized that it's all actually steel, and a lot of it is just coated with copper. Here's a cow magnet. You can see that's a nice looking piece of copper wire that's magnetic. And same with all this stuff down here. You take a magnet, and it's all steel wire. It's just copper coated. Here's the non-magnetic stuff. This is what went under the cross belt magnet. And this is all your non-ferrous and plastic. And so this can go on to further separation, probably by a granulator and an air separation table. Or maybe a eddy current after it's been liberated more with a smaller screen in the hammer mill. And here's our There's our magnet again. And there's hardly any magnetics that picked up, so that's all pretty clean. So we finished our samples. Mark, we've got your three different samples here, the magnetics and the non-magnetics. So we're going to bag some of this up for you and send it back to Germany. And you can analyze them and see what you think. So everyone else, thanks for watching our videos, and we'll see you on the next one.